Good morning. In the course PH8252, Physics for Information Science, in today's session, we will discuss about quantum free electron theory. As a part of this discussion, we will get to know the relevance of Fermi distribution function and density of states in deriving the carrier concentration in metals. To start with, we will first see what is Fermi distribution function. The quantum free electron theory is based on Sommerfeld's proposal that electrons are fermions obeying Fermi Dirac statistics. Sommerfeld proposed electrons are fermions. When I say electrons are fermions, it means they are identical, indistinguishable. Indistinguishable having half integral spin a spin of plus half or minus half obeying Pauli exclusion principle and is governed by Fermi distribution function or Fermi Dirac statistics. It is given as f of e equal to 1 by 1 plus e power e minus ef by kT. Here k is Boltzmann constant, T is absolute temperature, e is a particular energy level whose occupancy, probability of occupation is given by f of e. The probability that the energy level E is filled is given by the Fermi distribution function F of E. Here EF is what is known as the Fermi energy. In order to find what the Fermi energy is, we will be utilizing this expression of Fermi distribution function. At absolute zero, that is at T equal to 0 Kelvin, two cases arise. Energy, there are energies less than the Fermi energy and there are energies greater than the Fermi energy. For energies less than Fermi energy, the expression F of E becomes 1 by 1 plus e power minus infinity. E power minus infinity is 0, so F of E turns out to be 1, which means at 0 Kelvin, the probability of occupancy of all energy levels less than the Fermi energy is unity, that is 100% chance or probability of getting filled up. Whereas if E is greater than EF, F of E becomes 1 by 1 plus e power infinity, which is nothing but 1 by infinity, which turns out to be 0. That is, at absolute 0, all energy levels greater than the Fermi energy are completely empty. That is, they are having a probability of occupancy equal to 0. So, to plot this, at the Fermi energy, the probability of occupation is 1 till the Fermi energy. And for all energy levels above the Fermi energy, the probability of occupation is 0. So this is the graph at absolute 0, that is at 0 Kelvin. At any other temperature T, at any T for E equal to EF, you will have F of E to be equal to 1 by 1 plus e power 0, that is half. So whatever be the temperature, the probability of occupation of the Fermi level is going to remain half. So this is 0.5, and to be drawn in the form of a graph, it will look like this. That is, energy levels to the left of E will be having a probability of occupation slightly less than unity, and energy level EF is going to have a probability of occupation of 0.5, and energy levels greater than EF are going to have a probability of occupation slightly greater than 0. So let this be temperature T. For a further increase in temperature, there will be still more energy levels interacting. So this is T1 greater than T. So this is the variation of the Fermi distribution function with respect to temperature. At absolute zero, it is the probability of occupation till EF remains 1, and beyond EF for energy levels greater than EF, the probability of occupation is 0. Whereas as temperature increases, energy levels close to EF on either side, that is both lesser as well as greater than EF, participate in the interaction. So this graph not only shows the variation of the Fermi distribution function with respect to temperature, it also gives a very important result that unlike classical particles, where all the particles right from zero energy level to the highest occupied level, all the particles participate in interaction. Whereas fermions have the tendency that only fermions with energy close to the Fermi level participate in interaction. So there lies the relevance of the Fermi level and also the quantum statistics, the Fermi Dirac statistics. It is one of the major difference between the classical Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics as well and the Fermi-Dirac statistics. So now, based on this graph and these results, we will set out to define what is Fermi energy. Fermi energy is the highest occupied energy level at absolute zero. This is an interpretation from the graph and from these results. For all energies less than EF at absolute zero, the probability of occupancy is 1. That is, all the energy levels less than the Fermi level are filled, and all energy levels greater than the Fermi level are empty because they are having a probability of occupancy of 0. At any other temperature, the Fermi level has a probability of occupancy of half or 50% probability of occupation. It is the energy level with 50% probability of occupation at any other temperature T. So here runs the definitions of Fermi energy. So the Fermi distribution function is giving us a method to find the probability of occupation of a particular energy level. But we don't know the number of energy states that are available for the electrons to be occupied. In order to find the number of energy states available, we set out to find the density of states. Density of states is number of energy states available for the electrons to be occupied per unit volume of the material in the energy range E and E plus dE. So, density of states is actually giving you the number of available energy states per unit volume in the material in the range E and E plus dE. So, for deriving the expression for density of states, we get back to the particle in a box model, preferably a three-dimensional box, where the free electrons are assumed to be an analog of particle in three-dimensional box. Recall the results from our discussion on particle in a box. The energy eigenvalue En is given as h square by 8m a square nx square plus ny square plus nz square. The free electrons within a metal are considered to be similar to particle in a three-dimensional box. Here we assume a cubical box of side A whose volume will be A cube. side of the cube is assumed to be A. Due to the restrictions or conditions that these quantum numbers nx, ny, nz should represent a physical system, nx, ny, nz are all positive integers. Nx, ny, nz are all positive integers. So, if we draw an n space nx, ny, nz, then the plot of nx, ny, nz is going to be a set of discrete points, unlike a continuum in most graphs. Because nx can be 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Similarly, ny can be 1, 2, 3, so on. And similarly, nz can be one, take up only values 1, 2, 3, and so on. So, the set of points in the n space are just discrete points. Now, if we define a portion of a sphere, of radius say R, then in the n space R will be equal to square root of nx square plus ny square plus nz square. The number of total number of available states up to energy E. Here we assume E equal to this eigenstate En is given by the volume of the octant in this n space. The volume of the octant will be 1 by 8th of the volume of the sphere, which is 1 by 8, 4 by 3 pi r cube, which reduces to pi by 6 r cube. Let me denote the total number of states to be n of e. But we have r as square root of nx square plus ny square plus nz square. So, the total number of states available up to energy level E becomes pi by 6 nx square plus ny square plus nz square the whole power 3 by 2. But we know that E is 4 by 3, I'm sorry, 8 h square by 8ma square nx square plus ny square plus nz square. So this gives us nx square plus ny square plus nz square equal to 8ma square by h square e. So, substituting this value in the expression for the total number of states, we get n of e equal to pi by 6, 8m a square by h square e the whole power 3 by 2, which reduces to four pi by 3 h cube a cube e power 3 by 2. Of course 2m the whole power 3 by 2. Okay. So we are actually density of states is total number of states available per unit volume in the range E and E plus DE. So we have N here. To find the total number of states in the energy range E and E plus DE, we need to differentiate N. So dN will give you 4 pi by 3 h cube a cube 2m the whole power 3 by 2 e power half 3 by 2 dE. So that reduces to 2 pi by h cube a cube 2m the whole power 3 by 2 e power half dE. But the density of states d of e dE is 2 times dN by a cube. That is number of states between the energy level E and E plus dE. This factor 2 accounts for Pauli's exclusion principle. This is density of states. And remember, we have defined the density of states as number of energy states available per unit volume in the range E and E plus dE. The factor 2 is introduced here to account for Pauli exclusion principle. That is, every energy state is occupied by two electrons, one with spin half and another with spin minus half. So when you substitute for dN here, when you reduce this expression, you have the expression for density of states d of E dE equal to 4 pi by h cube 2m the whole power 3 by 2 e power half dE. So when you plot the density of states versus E, it's going to be a curve like this. The number of electrons per unit volume or carrier concentration is the number of electrons per unit volume, and it is given by N equal to integral of the probability of occupancy of energy level E, density of times the density of state डी ऑफ ई डी ई. एट एब्सोल्यूट जीरो द कैरियर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड एज 0 टू ई एफ, एफ ऑफ ई इज 1 अप टू इज टाइम्स डी ऑफ ई डी. So when you substitute the expression d of e d e here and when you solve, you get the carrier concentration at absolute zero to be equal to 4 pi by h cube 2m the whole power 3 by 2 e f naught, because here the Fermi energy, since you are substituting the Fermi energy at absolute zero, it is EF naught, EF naught power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2. So when you reduce that, you get N naught, the carrier concentration, to be equal to 8 pi by h cube 2m the whole power 3 by 2 8 pi by 3 h cube EF naught power 3 by 2. On rearranging this expression, you can also find the Fermi energy at absolute zero, which turns out to be h square by 2m 3n by 8 pi the whole power 2 by 3. So we have got an expression for, we have got an expression for carrier density or carrier concentration, that is number of free electrons per unit volume. We have got an expression for carrier concentration as well as for Fermi energy at absolute zero. In this discussion, we have discussed quantum free electron theory in detail based on the particle in a three-dimensional box model. We have seen what is Fermi distribution function, and we have defined Fermi energy based on the Fermi distribution function. We have arrived at an expression for density of states based on the particle in a three-dimensional model of electrons within a metal, and we have arrived at an expression for carrier concentration of electrons in a metal. An oft-repeated university exam question runs like this. Explain the concept of density of states. Explain the concept of density of states. Derive an expression for it. Derive an expression for density of states. Using the expression find the carrier concentration and Fermi energy at absolute zero. So this question will carry a full 16 mark, and I hope after listening to today's lecture you must be able to answer this question in a crisp and precise manner. The concept of density of states has been stated and the derivation done in detail. So this portion may carry a substantial 8 marks defining and deriving the expression for density of states. And then using that derivation, you have to calculate the carrier concentration. So the derivation of the carrier concentration, which we saw just now, will carry a 4 mark. And from the deduction of the carrier concentration, you must deduce the Fermi energy. The Fermi energy at absolute zero. So that will carry another 4 marks. This may be the rubric for this question. Yet another question that has been asked. Write the Fermi distribution function and discuss its behavior with respect to temperature. Also represent it graphically. So we have discussed in detail about the Fermi distribution function, its variation with respect to temperature, and the graphical representation as well, and also the importance of the Fermi level. Only energy levels close to the Fermi level on either side, either less than Fermi energy or greater than Fermi energy, only the energy levels lying very close to the Fermi level, as seen in this graph, only energy levels very close to the Fermi energy level on either side participate in interaction. That is a major difference between the quantum statistics and classical statistics. So you have to discuss the relevance here, and this question is asked as a part of a 16 mark question for say 6 marks. So here writing the Fermi distribution function may carry 2 marks. Discussing its behavior, how f of e varies with temperature, that may carry another 2 marks, and representing it graphically will carry another 2 marks. So I hope the discussion on the quantum free electron theory, the Fermi distribution function, the concept of density of states and derivation of carrier concentration and Fermi energy at absolute zero are clear to you. All the best for your examination.